How do line, shape, and form affect our experience of an artwork? What relationships do these elements have with each other? Let's begin by looking at line. A line is a path that a point makes when moving through space. A line can run horizontally or vertically. When used together, horizontal and vertical lines give a sense of space by implying width and height. This combination can make things look stable and solid. In contrast, diagonal lines can convey a feeling of movement and dynamism. They also add the impression of depth by suggesting recession into the distance. Lines are not always straight. Gentle, curving lines can create a pleasing, harmonious composition. Twisting, writhing lines can evoke energy and the fluid expression of emotion. The graphic effect that lines create can also be a rich subject matter in itself. Now, let's look at shape and its connection to line. Shapes are two-dimensional structures enclosed by lines. They have height and width. They can be geometric or organic. Geometric shapes like squares and triangles are mathematically regular. They are constructed using lines, angles, and points. Organic or biomorphic shapes are irregular structures that occur in the natural world. Artists sometimes explore the relationships between shapes in their compositions. Let's take a look at line and shape in Pagoda II by the Malaysian artist Latiff Mohidin. The work is an abstracted expression of temple architecture in Southeast Asia. Jagged lines and triangles are used to depict the tiered, ornate temple roofs. A bell-like hemisphere is rendered with sloping lines. This evokes a stupa, a key feature of Buddhist architecture. Latiff also explores the repetitive stacking of geometric shapes. This reminds us of pagodas found in Buddhist and Taoist architecture. The shapes in this composition are meticulously decorated with intricate line work. This recalls the elaborate ornamentation that typically adorns a temple. Latiff's masterful use of line and shape ensures that its subject matter is still recognizable to us, despite its abstraction. Latiff Mohidin is a painter, sculptor, and poet from Malaysia. In 1949, he moved to Singapore for his early education. His artistic talent was recognized from a young age, with his first solo exhibition in 1951, when he was just 10 years old. He received a scholarship to study painting in Germany from 1960 to 1964. Upon graduation, he traveled extensively around Southeast Asia until 1969. After which, he was awarded scholarships to study printmaking in Paris and New York. Southeast Asian nature, culture, and architecture have continued to form the basis of his artistic practice. Before we move on to the second work, let's explore form. Form is an element that is closely related to shape and line. Where shape is a two-dimensional structure, form is three-dimensional. In addition to height and width, form also has depth. In art, these qualities are clearly present in the medium of sculpture. Like shapes, forms can be geometric and angular, or organic and freeform. Artists sometimes create naturalistic forms that closely resemble their real-life equivalents. Other times, they construct forms that are abstract or stylized. When artists manipulate form, they can challenge our assumptions about volume and space. Let's take a closer look at form and line in this work by the Singaporean artist Han Sai Por. Tropical Life consists of three granite sculptures. Their organic forms are constructed through use of sinuous lines. The contour of these bulbous forms recalls the human body. A curving line inward suggests a slender waist. Converging fluid lines bring to mind a crouched figure. In this work, Han plays with form and line to counter our expectations of the physical qualities of her material. The soft, flesh-like forms and their curving lines stand in contradiction to their hard material and heavy weight. Han Sai Por is known for her stone sculptures based on figurative forms and organic shapes. Han was trained in fine art and landscape architecture in Singapore and the United Kingdom. She founded the Sculpture Society Singapore in 2001. The society remains dedicated to the nurturing of public appreciation for sculpture. Her works have been exhibited internationally and can be found in many public institutions and sculpture parks in Singapore. Line, shape, and form are key elements that artists use in the expression of their subject matters. Skillful control can help achieve lifelike representations that give a sense of volume and depth. Artists can also create captivating and evocative works by experimenting with these elements.